Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Good morning to all the dear students. Today I am taking question number 5 of chapter number 11. Bank reconciliation statement. Question number 5, case book of Naresh. So credit bank balance of bank rupees 12,000 as on 31st December 2016, which does not tally with the bank with the balance as per the passbook. Following information is obtained while comparing the passbook and case book. Prepare a bank reconciliation statement. So in this sum, bank overdraft as per case book is given. So here we record bank overdraft as per passbook. Question number 5. Bank overdraft as per the passbook. Bank overdraft as per the passbook has credit balance. If bank overdraft as per the bank overdraft as per the case book is given, so bank overdraft as per the case book has a credit balance. Now the next one is there, transaction number 1. A check of rupees 10,000 was deposited with the bank on 28 March 2016, which is not recorded in the passbook by bank. So we deposited check in the bank. Our bank balance as per the case book increased by the 10,000, but it is remain stable as per the passbook. So we record here our bank balance as per the case book increase. So check deposited into bank but not recorded in passbook. So we pass the in credit side by 10,000. Second, interest credited by bank of rupees 160 on 30 March 2016 is not recorded in casebook. So interest credited by the bank, it's our income. It is recorded in passbook but not recorded in casebook. So bank interest not recorded in casebook, 160. Transaction number 3, a customer has deposited rupees 10,000 directly in bank account, which is not known till 31st March 2016. So when customer deposited money in the bank, our bank balance as per passbook increase, but our bank balance as per casebook is not increase. So we record here a customer directly deposited amount in the bank, $10,000. Now the next one, fourth number, check deposited with bank but not recorded in casebook, rupees 8,000. We deposited check into the bank. Our bank balance as per passbook is increased, but it is not recorded in casebook. So we record here check deposited into bank but not recorded in casebook 8000. Now the transaction number 5, check drawn and paid by bank but not recorded in casebook. Check issued and paid by bank but not recorded in casebook. So when bank issued a check, our bank balance as per passbook is decreased. It is not recorded in casebook. So we record in casebook. In BRS it is recorded in a credit side 6 number. A bill receivable of rupees 3000 discounted with bank is dishonored, and bank has recovered the amount in passbook including noting charges of rupees 40 which is not known to Naresh. So there is a bill, it is discounted or dishonored by dishonor, and bank charges rupees 40 as a noting charges which is not recorded in casebook. So we pass the entry with the 3000 plus 40, that means 3040 rupees. So here we record 6 number. A bill is dishonored and bank credits the amount with noting charges. So it is recorded in BRS credit side 3040 because that is a bill dishonored. 7 number, total of receipt side of case book short by rupees 2000. So total is short, so we receipt side, that means debit side. So in BRS it is recorded debit side, receipt side total of case book is undercast 2000. Now the 8th number, check drawn but not presented for the payment rupees 1000. Check drawn but not presented for the payment. So when we drawn the check, it is recorded in casebook credit side, but it is not presented for the payment till the last day of the month. So we record here check issued but not presented for payment. We record in BRS in debit side. Now the 9 number is there, check deposited but not credited in bank rupees 1500. So check deposited, so when we deposited check, bank balance increased as per the casebook but not recorded in passbook. So we record in BRS credit side but not credited by bank 1500. 10 number, Bank has debited commission of ₹80 in passbook, which is not recorded in casebook. So bank has debited. So in BRS we record in credit side. So bank commission debited by bank but not recorded in casebook. But not recorded in casebook. ₹80 in credit side. Now all the transactions are completed. Now find the do the total and find out the difference. So total, both side total, we record 32,620. Difference 11,460. That difference, it is known as a bank overdraft as per passbook. 11,460. Okay, now dear student, all the transactions are completed here, and find out, and we find bank overdraft as per the passbook. Now your sum is over. Now you have to do the remaining sum as a homework for the more practice. Thank you very much.